I'd like to call to order the regular council meeting Tuesday, March 28th, 2017. Can I have a roll call, please?
Mr. Sorese?
Here.
Mr. Roden?
Here.
Mrs. Stoffer? Mr. Fury?
Here.
Mr. Scafidi?
Here.
Mr. Steele?
Here.
Ms. McFerrin?
Here.
Now, if you would rise, Mr. Scafidi will lead us in the invocation and the pledge.
Father, you guide and govern everything with order and love. Look upon the assembly of our city's leaders and fill us with the spirit of your wisdom. May we always act in accordance with your will and the decisions be for the peace and well-being of all. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Next, we have the approval of the minutes from the March 14th meeting. Are there any corrections, additions?
No, we're good.
So the minutes from March 14th will be approved as written. Next, we have audience participation. Before we begin, I'm going to read the rules of audience participation. Person who's addressing council has already signed in must identify themselves in their address. They will be called in the order that they signed in. It says one of the rules is no more than three persons to speak on the same topic, but we're not going to really worry about that this evening if there's more than three. Persons will speak on the issue that they signed in to speak about. Persons granted the floor shall address their remarks to the President of Council and shall not engage council members or other officers of the city to debate. Tirades are not permitted, nor shall any person utter any profanity, derogatory, contemptuous, slanderous, harassing, mean-spirited, malicious, or false comments or remarks. You are limited to 5 minutes. Please listen for Shannon. She'll tell you when you have a minute left. I hate to have to cut someone off, so please try to get your remarks done within the 5 minute period. And the members of council may respond during the audience participation by the leave of the president. Audience participation is not expected to exceed 1/2 hour. Again, if we go over that's not a big deal to me. But those are the rules of audience participation. Shannon, call the first, please.
First, we have Mike DiCillo.
Good evening, Mayor, Council.
Good evening.
My address is 11296 Palmer Lane. I'm sure everybody knows that. On March 16th, I attended my last Architectural Review Board meeting. My term was up. I did not choose to get reappointed. The last year and a half have been very trying on me. It was a very difficult decision. It wasn't the main decision, but that's why I didn't reapply. I had a very enjoyable time, and I would like to take this opportunity to thank this council for giving me the privilege to serve on the Architectural Review Board. I've been honored to serve with the distinguished members, both past and present. The board makeup is varied and very knowledgeable. They're a very distinguished group. They are diligent and very dedicated to their jobs. I recall my first meeting when I was presented to the board and they asked for my background, members of which two of the members are still there. I was a bit nervous not knowing what to expect from that board, I was relatively new to Twinsburg. I had just moved in about a year and a half. But I knew one thing for sure, that the long-time residents of the city were going to be keeping their eye on me. I was very pleased to get through that interview. I would be remiss if I would not include this council. When I was interviewed over 9 years ago for my first appointment, Mr. Scafidi, Mr. Ceresi, and Mr. Fury were on that council. But the rest of you were not. The interview went well until I was asked one question, and I think it was Mr. Scafidi that asked the question, and I said, if you're looking for a yes man, I'm not your guy. Then I had second thoughts about saying that. I thought, boy, oh boy, I might have blew my chance. But then I was appointed, and I figured it didn't have an effect on the council. During my tenure on the Architects Review Board, and as a member past in another community, serving the public is a difficult job at best. I learned a long time ago that we don't agree on all issues. We have our differences, we have our opinions. I never hesitate to express mine. I'm sure you're all aware of that. But in the end, disagreements and arguments and discussions that are had, in the end, I think the residents still win, and that's a good thing. As I leave, I would like to say thank you again for allowing me the opportunity to serve, and for the rest of you on your terms that you're serving the city. Good luck, and God bless all of you.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Mr. DeSalle. I have a question. First of all, I'd like to thank you for your service, number one. We appreciate all that you've done for that board in the time that you served. But you sparked my curiosity. What was the question that I asked you? That you gave the response, I'm not a yes man.
I don't recall the exact question, but I only know what I answered.
It almost makes it sound like I said, will you do what we say?
No, I don't think that was
something
like that.
That wasn't the main of your comment.
That was
I would hate for these people and everybody on television to believe that.
No, I don't believe that was the question.
Okay, thank you. That's all I need to know. You cleared my name. I appreciate it.
Mr. Steele?
Mr. DeSilla, I had the pleasure last year of being the council rep to the ARB board, and I sat that end in Mr. Scafidi's seat right next to Mr. DeSillo all year, and I sure learned a lot. You did a wonderful job. You educated me, and I'll be honest, I was a little surprised when I didn't see your name going back on the board, but thanks for the time.
Mm-hmm. You're welcome.
Thank you.
Thanks, Mark.
Shannon, who's next?
Next is Lori Fasina.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Mr. Ceresi and Council and Mayor. My name is Lori Sasala Fasina, and I live at 2950 Cannon Road. I come to you tonight as a resident and a registered voter in the city. I'm a third generation on both my father and mother's side to live in the city of Twinsburg. I was born in the house I'm living in and have watched as my city has grown and prospered. I'm not opposed to that growth or prosperity, as long as it does not erase our history in the process. Twinsburg has a unique and wondrous history, a history that includes ethnic inclusion, countless courageous historic figures, and a most fervent passion for the pursuit of education of its citizens. That reverence for education is what I believe needs to be addressed. I offer each of you, and I'll give a copy to Karen, a copy of a letter I received from the Ohio Historical Society indicating that the Twinsburg Combined School, aka the old school, qualifies for a listing on the National Register of Historic Places. It qualifies in not only one, but two of the four categories given as evidence of its prominence in history and status for inclusion on the registry. I'm in the process of mailing the formal nomination form as we speak. I have also uncovered a wellspring of historic information indicating that not only is the building of historic prominence, but the ground that it is built on is of equal historic importance. I should also let you know that I have been involved in historic preservation for many years, one of my greatest successes being the restoration and charitable status of the Vermilion on the Lake Historical Community Center, the last ballroom on the Lake Erie Shores, volohio.org. I strongly urge you to reflect on this information given the vote that took place at last week's council meeting. I would also respectfully assert that you actually listen to, consider, and respect our residents, and follow our city's charter, section 1170, providing for the preservation of our historic sites. Do you want your legacy to include the bulldozing of a historic Twinsburg landmark on the eve of the 200th anniversary of our city? And I'll close with this. We, as the citizens of Twinsburg, request additional meeting to discuss this. Thank you.
Thank you.
Next, Michael Turrell.
Good evening, Council and Mayor. Michael A. Turrell, 9930 Forest Lake Drive. I would like to take a minute to thank Mr. DeCillo as well for his years of service on the Architectural Review Board, and kind of tying into our second conversation there, talk about not being a yes man. He was one of the few that stood up when we were pursuing preservation of the old school and helped lead our decision that 3.5 years ago about the demolition permit being refused at the time. It was really interesting seeing the gentleman from Sylphia here earlier with their presentation about the dispensary and all of that, and their spot on the agenda, and he was able to make a nice full presentation, which was good because you can get an idea of what they're really wanting to do with their business and with and for the city. We asked for that back then, and I don't know if we didn't follow proper procedures, but with all the information that our committee has recently uncovered about Twinsburg Old School with the possible listing on the National Historic Register, the incredible amount of money that will be available to renovate this, that we can do this at very little cost to the residents, I hope that we can look forward to the same kind of process, that we can get our spot on the agenda, that we can make a full and proper presentation to council and to the city of Twinsburg, that they can fully understand instead of getting tiny little sound bites and 5 minutes at a time or little blurbs on Facebook, that we can make an actual presentation as to how we can fund and finance this project and what it can actually be and do for our community. So thank you very much. I look forward to working with you.
Thank you.
Next, Dan Siphon.
Good evening, Council and Mayor.
Good evening.
My name is Dan Siphon at 2275 Meadowwood Boulevard. And I would also like to disclose before I start to the audience that I currently hold a resident position on the Twinsburg CIC. However, any comments that I make tonight are mine alone. So I grew up in Rhineville Village and attended the Twinsburg City Old School and graduated from Twinsburg High School in 1996. I attended the old school from grades K through 5. That was 1983 through 1989. I have many fond memories of my time there. I took part in the sledding parties on the famous hill behind the old school. I paraded around the playground in my Halloween costumes. I remember being in a lunchroom in 1986 when an earthquake hit, rattling my lunch tray in front of me. All the while, we were trying to process the Challenger disaster that happened just a few days before that. In 1992, when the old school closed, I was admittedly saddened that the setting of so many childhood memories was vacated. When the building came back to life, when the UAW moved in and later Kent State, I never looked at it the same way. For me, the legacy of the building is as a school. It will never be that again. Looking at that building, sitting silent over the past few years, it's hard to conjure up those memories again. Twinsburg has changed a lot over those 30 plus years that I've lived in the community, and I believe that's a good thing. I'm here tonight as a proponent of saying goodbye to that building and laying new ground for Twinsburg's future. I know that there are many who do not share my view. I understand and respect that. But as our council, we empower you with tough decisions. Remember that at some point down the road, everyone who actually attended that school here will be gone. What will be left for our future generations? An empty building continue to sit in darkness in the middle of our town? Or will we finally begin the process of creating our own history, helping the city to grow with the tools that we already have in place so we control our own destiny? As I stated earlier, I understand the feelings of those who do not agree with me. I admire their passion and their efforts for trying to save the building. And I'm okay with the anger that the demolition would cause. What I do reject is the idea that others who feel the same as I do somehow do not respect our history or that we do not care about the city. If you have an opinion on the matter, then you care. Otherwise, we would not be here. I would just ask that everyone involved in the conversation remember that. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Next, Kelly Brown.
Good evening, everybody. My husband, daughter, and I own four properties on the east side of Route 91 between the vacant school building and the property next to the post office. We are here tonight to make council aware of recent statements and actions taken by a group called Friends of Twinsburg Old School. Last week, a member of this group posted the names, addresses, and phone numbers of all of our commercial tenants in Twinsburg, with the suggestion that residents and non-residents contact our tenants and inform them that the city of Twinsburg would be taking their property by eminent domain and then leveling the buildings. We feel this malicious action is blatantly damaging to both our family as well as our tenants. Not only do we rely on the continued occupancy of these buildings to pay mortgages and taxes, this is how we make a living. Twinsburg City Schools, as well as the city itself, receive substantial revenue from our businesses. Since this group feels the right to unjustly bring our family into their failed attempts to save the vacant school, we feel it necessary to make this group, as well as fellow residents and city official, aware of our past history in Twinsburg and why we feel this action is so offensive. We purchased our first property in 1979, which was the Victorian at 8963 Darrell Road. This is a house that sits a few feet from the curve of State Route 91. This building's footprint actually encroaches the Route 91 right-of-way by approximately 4 feet. This property had been on the market for quite a long time when we first looked at it, probably due to its advanced state of disrepair. We recall that the line of local activists interested in trying to save this old building was quite short, in fact, was non-existent. Over the next 20 years, we continued to make investments into our part of the town, Square that is situated on one of the main entrances into our city. By purchasing and repurposing the three more buildings, we took a blighted stretch of the town and made it presentable. Once again, there were no other historic-centric Twinsburgers there to try their hand at the lucrative business of paying and do whatever restoration work it takes to make an old building habitable in the 21st century. In fact, over the last 30 years we've been in this town, there have been multiple other opportunities to snatch up one of these old buildings, and once again, none of this group felt motivated to risk their time or money. From what we have recently learned, it appears two of the most vocal members of the Save Our History group had been members of families that owned property near the square and along Ravenna Road that was sold to developers to build shopping centers and cluster homes. I have to ask, does this sound as ridiculous and hypocritical to you as it does to us? They have now posted pictures of all the homes we have restored and repurposed, pictures that show that we have done exactly as they advocate. And then they bizarrely declare us as blasphemous. In our opinion, these bizarre and strange comments and actions directed at our family are both concerning and unacceptable. When we consider the years of investment and maintenance we have provided to make this main entrance to our city both pleasant and cohesive, we take offense to this group's effort to alarm our tenants to advance their agenda. A rough calculation of our total contribution of 30 years of taxes, property taxes, income taxes paid by hundreds of employees, and the support of local businesses provided by these people show we have easily contributed over $1 million into our city. Not only has this school group failed to contribute or produce anything to advance revenue growth for our city, they are now attempting to jeopardize our ability to continue to successfully manage our business. As far as other properties surrounding our square, we feel they have intentionally stifled any potential for our city to make the necessary progress expected of any well-managed and progressive community.
Time.
Our current tenants enjoy the facilities and location we provide, and we take exception to any one or group that attempts to unduly disrupt our many years of hard work. As far as the citizens of Twinsburg outside of this group that seems determined to put our town into a death spiral, take a look around our town square. When our family arrived here in 1979, we purchased the book History of Twinsburg from Miss Bissell at our first Twins Day. It described our founders well enough for us to know that the reason they traveled 600 miles from Connecticut to Twinsburg was to create something new.
Your time is up.
And exciting. Thank you.
Thank you.
Next, we have Daisy Walker.
This would be a change of pace.
Yeah.
Good evening, Mr. Mayor.
Good evening.
Council and staff. Daisy Walker, Chair, Twinsburg Environmental Commission. And, I thought my voice was loud enough. And I'm here to thank the sponsors that helped on our Earth Day project. A special thanks to Summit Metro Parks because they partner with the Environmental Commission on our annual Earth Day celebration at Liberty Park Nature Center. And the event will take place on Saturday, April 22nd from 12 noon to 4 p.m. And these are our sponsors. A special thanks to Mustard Seed Solon. They're donating 100 tree saplings, white cedar, red maple, and red and white oak. Lowe's in Macedonia, they're giving us two $25 gift cards. Home Depot in Macedonia and Aurora, they're giving us four $25 gift cards. Coleman's Greenhouse, one $50 gift card, and the gift cards are going to be used for prizes at Earth Day. Giant Eagle, 100 sorted apples. Vistar at Cornerstone, they're giving us assorted candy, snacks, and cookies, and they're very generous when they do that. Five Below, we have 48 emojis. Parks and Rec, a family pool pass, which is our grand prize. Tom Lilly, I think he's here in the audience now, and he will be presenting a rain garden display. The Humane Society, they will be bringing in a truck with animals to adopt. There's a theater group, and they'll be doing a skit on clean water. We're going to have samples of yoga classes. Pepsi and Twinsburg, they will be sponsoring water and refreshments for X amount of people that will be coming to Earth Day. If we have 500 people, they'll donate 500 refreshments, you know, of pop in water. Coca-Cola in Twinsburg, they're donating 50 rain barrels. They have 28 rain barrels for us to pick up. I did talk to Chris Campbell this afternoon, and they will be picking up those rain barrels this week and storing them in Public Works. Huntington Bank, they're donating a $300 scholarship, and that will be going to a high school student who's majoring in environmental studies. That presentation will be at the last council meeting in April, which is April 25th. Liberty Ford is bringing 4 hybrid electric cars. Spitzer, Chevrolet, and Macedonia, they're bringing anywhere from 2 to 4 hybrid cars. And last but not least, we're trying to get Post Hill Farms to bring in a couple of ponies so the kids can come and ride a pony or take their pictures with the pony. A special thanks to Mayor for listening to me on Monday and supporting Earth Day. Special thanks to Council for supporting the Environmental Commission and all that we do, not only with your approving of the projects that we do, but also your participation. And also to thanks again for our sponsors, because they are so generous and they are so nice and they are so kind. Not only do they give, some of them come out and participate. And like I will always say, this is the best city, and I'm really blessed to be on the Environmental Commission. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks, Daisy.
And last we have Dwayne Smith.
Hello, Council. Dwayne Smith, 10225 Darrow Road. I won't take up much time. I really just wanted to come up here and applaud the decision to finally take a hard stance on getting numbers for progress for the city. You know, at least if we could find out what it would cost, what we'd be looking at to, you know, demo the old school, if that's what it comes to. Again, progress to me is what we need to see. I'm not a third generation Twinsburger. I moved here 13 years ago, but my kids live here. My kids are going to grow up here. I hope that my kids stay here. So to me, I care about the city. I care about the future of the city. I care about the mic. So to me, it's not a matter of just keeping the old school or getting rid of the old school. It's a matter of just finding something that's going to be feasible for the city for the long term. As far as the actual school is concerned, it's not the first school that was in town. It's not the second school that was in town. I have no ties to the building. I understand that there's sentimental value to a lot of people, and like Dan said, I appreciate that, and that's their passion's fantastic. But again, I hear them throw around the word "we." You know, we the citizens, you know, want to keep the school. I'm not tied to the school, and I know a lot of other people that just again want to see progress. So, and I hear, you know, Mr. Turrell talks about the presentation and the opportunity for a presentation. I welcome it. I mean, I show us a presentation that we will see what can happen. If the presentation happens and it's not the best thing for the city, so be it. That's fine. Let's move on and get over it. But again, we're you know, no offense, we're 3 or 4 years later, and I haven't heard anything about their progress or what's going to happen with the school. So. I just want an end to the whole thing, and I want to just see the progress for the city. So that's all I wanted to say.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
That's it?
That's it.
Okay.
I'd like to make just a quick comment. First of all, thank Daisy. just Earth Day is going to be a fantastic event. It's at the Nature Center this year, so we're really looking forward to that. As it relates to some of the comments that were made, I guess in my mind, you know, this has been going on for 3 to 4 years. It really shouldn't be a surprise that the council wants to get hard numbers on the demolition. I mean, we talked about progress. We've talked about redevelopment. Mr. Turrell has mentioned a plan. He's mentioned funding. He's mentioned a number of things. And to his specific question, how you get on an agenda to do a presentation, well, Mr. Moorhead set an appointment with me, came in with that particular presentation, so it looked like I wasn't really watching at times because I've seen that whole presentation. It was packaged together, as you saw today. It was very well put together. I've met with Mr. Turrell probably 3 or 4 times this year. Three or four times this year. A couple of them have been spontaneous. He showed up. I welcomed him back to my office. Some have been scheduled. Ample opportunities to sit down with an entire proposal with grants or with, you know, the economic package. And I shared with Mike. I said, you know, at least the vision that I share, if it incorporates a redevelopment of that entire area that would fit the old school, not just focused on one building. I think that's the whole bigger picture that I think when we talk about progress that we're looking at. My door's always open. I mean, there's been ample opportunity, I think, to sit down with me. I don't know if council's ever sat down with anyone that's had, you know, a hard presentation on anything, but that's how you get in front of council on this kind of stuff. So, you know, and just to hear the things that people have sent me, I mean, to talk about eminent domain and the nerve of handing out addresses and phone numbers of business tenants, I mean, if you do a little bit of research on eminent domain law, you know, 2006 Norwood Horney was a huge case that now prohibits taking a property for economic development purposes. I mean, that should jump out of your Google screen if you do any kind of research on that issue. So that's not going to happen. That's impossible to happen. I was actually part of a firm that rewrote the law that now prohibits that. So it's absurd to think that that's being thrown out on social media or anything. Of course, there's a lot of things on social media that's absurd. But, you know, that is, you know, eminent domain can happen for roadway purposes, different things that a municipality can do. So, you know, there's a lot that's going on, and again, I think if you've got questions about anything, before you start regurgitating things that you think are appropriate on social media or out in the public, just call us and ask. I mean, just call and ask questions. I mean, I've never turned down a phone call. I've never turned down a meeting with Mike. I've answered questions, I think, for him. Our door's open. If we don't know it, we'll find the answer. But to just start blatantly putting stuff out there on social media, I mean, it's just, you know, it is absurd. I mean, all council did was a motion to get an estimate on a demolition. That's it. That's what we're going to do. There's been nothing further that they've approved. They just want to see numbers. So, and I support them with that. So, that's all I have.
Thank you. Council Communications. Mr. Scafidi.
Good evening. Well, they're surprised. My committees have not met, therefore I have no report tonight. Thank you.
Mr. Fury.
Thank you.
Wait, I'm going to talk about they don't leave.
This evening we had a finance committee at 6 o'clock. The items we discussed were putting in reserve funds. In the past, prior to the tax increase that was put in about 6 or 7 years ago, we used to put 20% of the revenue that was generated from the income tax into a capital improvement fund. We got away from that as we tried to make sure that we had a lot of flexibility with the general fund, but Karen House, our finance director, has recommended that we go back and revisit putting in reserves. So we're going to get with the law director and the mayor and recommend that we start to set aside 20% of the revenue collected up to $19.6 million to be split 50-50 between the capital and the SCMR fund. And also put a provision in that council by a motion can suspend it for at a 90-day period. so that if we have an issue where we have a return of revenue that happens at times, we can do that. But what this will do is build up the bank accounts or the savings accounts for the roads and the capital projects that will be that the city uses every year. Those are the two largest non-general fund expenditures are the capital and the SMR fund. SMR, we also get revenue in from income or from the state for road repair. We also discussed doing some analysis of what it costs to provide services for our surrounding communities and other entities to make sure that we understand that when we're bartering with other people to go back and forth, that we understand what the cost is and make sure that we are not giving away city resources to other entities. Karen House is going to work with Shannon to pull some numbers together from the department heads. I think that there's already been work done on this, but if we're going to offer services to other people, we should understand what those costs are. And the next Finance Committee meeting will be April 25th at 6 p.m. I attended a tax incentive review meeting. This is an annual meeting that's held with the schools, the city, and the county to review the top agreements, which are Twinsburg occupancy permits, or if you're bringing a business into an existing building, we give you an income tax break on the new income tax or new employees that you're bringing, as well as the CRA agreements, which are community reinvestment agreements, where they're either building or adding on to a facility, and we give you we negotiate a break on the property tax of the new construction. There's probably a dozen of these programs that we've reviewed. Every one of them, in order to continue or to be amended, will have to come up for a resolution. So in the next month or so, we'll have probably a dozen pieces of legislation to either continue or to amend the program. But, you know, when we give an abatement, either for income tax or property tax, they're reviewed to make sure that the person that got that benefit is living up to the commitments they made to the community. And if you're not, and we can't see a way to get you to that, we reduce the commitment or even terminate the contract. So this is a way that we can communicate with the schools as well as the city where we're at on these abatements, which are important tools that we need to use to be competitive in bringing in and retaining businesses in Twinsburg. So extremely important, and because if we don't offer these, our neighbors and other cities do. So we have to remain competitive. There was also a Park and Rec meeting on April 27th at 6:30, and I was contacted this weekend by a resident to ask me, had we done eminent domain in the past? So I posted something that just said simply, and Sam and I were talking about this. Yeah, I don't recall that we've even discussed an eminent domain case prior to 2006, because I was aware that we weren't allowed to do them now. But in 2003, 4, and 5, well, there was nothing at all regarding the utilization of eminent domain by the city of Twinsburg. I also wanted I asked for another copy because I hadn't reviewed it in a while. But you know, 6 or 7 years ago, when Chrysler first moved out of the old school, you know, we talked about how we could get people, and we advertised for people to come in and utilize the old school. And we even had a group do a survey with multiple facility options that was done in May of 2011. I have a soft copy. Shannon or I can email this to you if you'd like to read it. But, you know, it's a 25-page report going over the size and types of entities that would occupy the old school. And part of that study recommended that you couldn't do anything with this with the old school in its current state. So we authorized a year later to get a report that's probably 100 pages, I didn't count them, done by a local architect to, in detail, tell us what they thought the issues were with the building, as well as, you know, get estimates on what it would cost to fix the building through the building codes, ADA, roofing, windows, mechanical replacements, electrical replacements, plumbing, and fire system replacements. And in 2012, five to six years ago, the low end was $5 million and the high end was $9 million. So we've looked at that. We've also had estimates done by what economic development could take place in a C5 district, which is downtown, similar to what Hudson does, where there's office spaces that are above retail storefronts to try to get traffic downtown so that the other businesses there can survive. So if anybody would like to see these reports, they're available either from contacting the clerk of council or myself. I'd be happy to email them to you. And that's all I have. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Roden?
Thank you. Mr. Ferry just talked about the finance committee that met this evening. And then I just want to talk about, we didn't meet, but as Daisy talked about and the mayor talked about, on Saturday, April 22nd from 12 to 4 p.m. Is the Earth Day celebration. We are going to celebrate this year at the Liberty Park Nature Center. We're going to be able to explore the Nature Center itself, the building, and then Earth Day exhibits. The ledges area, we can do, there's some trails and things like that you can walk through. Invasive and native plants to our region. We're going to see electric hybrid cars. And like Daisy talked about, the Humane Society will be there with their mobile adoption center. There's a lot of activity. I just want to thank Daisy and the committee and the commission, because when I started on this committee, what's it been, 8 years ago? And I've stayed on it all the way through. It was a small little tiny thing that we did at St. Rita's Church. So it's come a long way, and they've done a lot of hard work and a lot of time and effort, and I send a lot of kudos to them. They've worked really hard, and it's going to be a great weekend. So come out and help support the Earth Day celebration. Thank you. That's it for this evening.
Thank you. Mr. Steele.
None of my committees have met. I was here for the Finance Committee, I should say, and it was an interesting thing, and I think we're headed in the right direction trying to establish reserve funds for the city.
Thank you. Ms. McPherson.
None of my committees have met.
Okay. My committees haven't met either. The Twinsburg committee does meet next Wednesday, April 5th, at the Twinsburg office at 7 p.m. And I wanted to take a moment to thank Mike DeSillo for his time and effort on our behalf from the city. And we would truly appreciate it. And we thank you.
Can I say one thing?
Sure.
I'm sorry, I'd like to go back. But I did want to mention, and I forgot under my report, that and I for the Glenwood Acres residents that I have in Ward 1, with spring now upon us and going through my ward and looking at various things and things in need, I saw that Glenwood Acres is one of the probably the only areas in the city, well, at least in our ward anyway, that does not have a recognition sign naming the development. And so I had talked with the mayor and asked the mayor if we could do something about that. Can we get a sign put up? I know. We had a sign missing, I believe, in Brian's ward, and it was replaced last year. It came down for whatever reason, and the city had another one made and put it up. So I'm not sure where exactly this is going, but we will be putting up a sign designating Glenwood Acres, and I'm just happy that we're able to get that done. And Mayor, I appreciate you working with me with that, and we're going to get it done.
Good That's idea.
It.
Good
Thank
idea.
You.
Anyone else? Mayor.
All right. Thank you. Good evening, everyone. A couple things kind of going on. I want to, I guess, congratulate the high school drama club. I attended Cloud 7, which is a play they put on, and it was my understanding that very little time to practice, but it was a really, actually a really good performance that the drama club did, and we were able to attend that. Things coming up, you've got Coffee for a Cause that's going to be happening April 8th from 6:45 to 10 p.m. at the library. That's a big event that teens put on. They basically do coffee house type performances. They raise money for a charity. So I encourage you to come out for that. Things going on around the city. We've got a lot of security things going on here, putting in key fobs. We're going to security badges for all the employees. So if you see employees now wandering around with security badges attached to their hip and stuff, We're just trying to do that just so we can identify people here at City Hall. We met today, and we've been working with the fire department as well as Parks and Rec, and coordinated. So we're making a requirement that all of our city employees become CPR and first aid certified. We have a lot of them that already are, especially Parks and Rec, but we just, it's kind of hit and miss throughout the city, so we're really going to be pushing that over the next couple of weeks and getting everyone at the city certified. I was able to attend, so there was a trailer that was donated. So for those that don't know, we have a CERT team, our emergency response team here, that all volunteers in the city that do a fantastic job with a lot of our events and are, I guess, ready and mobilized if something major catastrophe happens here in Twinsburg. But someone donated a trailer, and they were able to make that into a mobile, like, command center. So it was fixed up, and it was, they can put it anywhere and operate a command center out of that. And VMS was gracious enough to do all the decaling on it. And then I wanted to thank, I reached out to a friend of mine that I knew that used to live in Twinsburg that works at Blackburn Wheels. So I want to thank Blackburn Wheels, because we have this beautiful new kind of looking trailer, and the wheels were kind of this beat up, white, rusted out wheels. So he was able to dress up the wheels for me, and I showed up. He sent me a text yesterday, said, I found the trailer, go look at the wheels. So he just came upon himself, ordered the, and went and spruced up the wheels for this trailer. So the CERT team was thrilled. But I just want to thank Todd, and it's kind of a neat story, but Todd, his name's Todd Duranik. I don't think he might be sharing this, but Todd was in a motorcycle accident about a year and a half ago, and spent, I believe, over a month in ICU. Lost a leg, was a fit guy, about the same age as me, but we're the ones that responded to it. And so through this, my reach out to him also prompted him to reach out to me and say, hey, can you get the names and of the officers and the firemen that responded to that scene that day? Because he goes, I really need to thank them, because he says, I'm just now at a point where I can do that. So it's kind of neat where I wasn't really reaching out to him for that, but it kind of opened the door for him to really want to reach out to those responders and really think about the people that you know, we have next door at our police and fire, because you know, Todd is someone that I think when they brought him in, it was about a 20% chance that he was actually going to come out of that hospital alive. So he's now doing well. He's a, you know, so it was a kind of a cool story that all kind of happened this week that I just wanted to share with everyone. Another thing that is going to be going on here in Twinsburg is, if you've ever been to Hudson in the summertime recently, they do a flea market and a kind of a market there. And I've been meeting with the organizer of that, and it looks like we have dates, and we're going to try to do four dates where we're going to do a really nice market and flea market, and there'll be produce, and there'll be food trucks, and a lot of different things in the summer at our square. So we've talked to the township, they're okay with it. I've talked with the businesses, the church there, to make sure we didn't interfere with any cleaning going on. So look for more information on that. This is just in really in the early stages, but it looks like it's going to happen here this summer. And really excited for that. I believe that's all I have. So I got some department head reports. We'll let Derek start since he's on vacation. And he came in.
That's more of a staycation, I guess. but yes, thanks. I hope you've all had a chance to look at the bicentennial book that's come out. I know we still have people calling there, so they didn't get the voucher. But if they didn't, they could contact the mayor's office. Morgan can help with that, or I can help with that, too. So just let us know. We'll make sure you get a voucher. I think it turned out very nice. If there are any changes from the book, we are putting them on the website. We obviously can't change the book since it's been out. But there were a few things that have already been changed that you can see on the website at twinsburg200.com to see the additions or corrections that are in the book. And then if you do like stories in the book and you think it should be elaborated more, check the website for that. We couldn't put everything in the book, so the website's going to be our living document, breathing document that's changing and updated from now until our next time we do a book. And the library is maintaining that part of this. So they're doing the website and making sure everything's updated. Right now we're in the middle of spring break camp over at the fitness center, and with regular camp signups coming up at the end of April, I think April 22nd, all the information on summer camp is online at twinsburgrecreation.com, so you can see all the dates. The only thing not updated yet are field trips, and those will be updated here probably next week or so. Safety Town is online as well, so you can see the Safety Town dates coming up in the summer. A couple of events coming up. We have the Adult Egg Hunt on April 7th. That event is completely sold out. There are no more tickets available for that. We have all of our candy scramble Easter with the bunny on April 15th. The mayor mentioned the market on the square, I think it's going to be the name of the flea market, and we'll be working with them a little bit just to get them in touch with some vendors that were a part of our farmers market now being a part of that event. So I think that's a great option. If you haven't been to the one in Hudson, it was a real cool setup, and I think we'll go over well here. Rock the Park is completely booked. We will announce our lineup probably next time I see you, probably mid-April, something like that. You'll see the lineup for Rock the Park. We are in crazy hiring mode. HR is probably going crazy with all of our seasonal staff, so lots of lifeguards, lots of day camp staff, volunteers all coming in, all paperwork, drug testing, background checks, all that good stuff is underway for the opening of the outdoor pool and summer camp. We are doing another kids-only summer theater camp. We're going to do The Lion King. Last year we did Winnie the Pooh, so we're going to do The Lion King this year. Most of the rehearsals and stuff will take place at the community center and then using RBC stage. Also at the community center, we're making an adjustment with our hours a little bit there, trying to make the fitness center our hub of registrations and reservations. So if you need to do anything, you can do it at the fitness center. Now they're open 7 days a week, you know, from 5 a.m. to almost 10 o'clock at night. So we're trying to focus on getting everyone down there to register for stuff. But that'll slowly, it's not going to happen immediately. We're going to kind of work that in. And speaking of the fitness center as well, we have the fitness center locker room project going on the pool side. If you guys happen to be out, you want a tour, see where it's at, just stop in, talk to TL or Jen or Brandon, they can show you. It is underway, but I will be coming to you probably the next council meeting with a change order to that. There's one thing we forgot, and then one thing we'd like to add on. One thing we forgot to add are benches, so that was never in the spec because the benches were mounted into the wall, you know, into the locker room, so those obviously got ripped out, so now we need to get some benches, so I need to add that back in. That was on me. Two other things we'd like to add, we have a hose bib connection, so we can just, you know, go in there and just spray down and, you know, do a good cleaning, so we'd like to add a hose bib into the locker. And then one of the biggest things, we were originally going to just paint over the small tiled walls, but the contractor's like, oh, that shouldn't have even been spec'd that way. You don't want to do that. You want to go in and you're going to know that it's painted tile. You know, so they want to go in and put a vapor barrier up and then smooth out all the grout indentation so it looks like a flat wall and then paint it. So I'm going to come back once I get all the quotes and everything together. I'm thinking it's going to be between $12,000 or $15,000 change order. So it was $169,000. It was allotted $240,000 for the project. We got a really, I think, competitive bid. So we're asking for a little bit more money for that. Yes, sir.
Is that total?
Total.
Okay. Are you up enough room for two benches down those lines, or are you just putting one in the middle?
No, it looks like, it depends on the sides of the bench. We've had a few different arrangements. Okay. We have one on each side and then two in the middle because we've taken out that middle wall.
Oh, great.
So the middle wall's gone now.
I've done a tour.
If you walk through there, if you get a chance, go through there.
It's
a lot more room.
Yeah, you're amazed how much bigger it looks.
I did take a tour. TL is very excited about it. Yeah. I can definitely tell you that. And it's much bigger than what it was. So it's actually going to be very nice.
Out that middle wall, I think the benefit is, you know, you had the benches that were attached and you had really wasted space from the bench down. Now we're going to have kind of floor up, different size lockers, and so we really shouldn't lose any space in there.
No, I think and it's weird too when you had to sit down and the locker was behind you. So now you can sit down and face your locker, you know, you can get your stuff. I'll get you in. I might have a sketch for how we're going to place the benches, but
I'll take a tour.
I
was just curious.
Just stop over anytime we'd like to take you through. So I'll get all the details to you. I'll probably send you an email so you have it before the meeting and you can email me back with any questions, but that's going to be coming here in the next week or so. And that's all I have, unless anyone has any questions.
Thank you.
Thank you. Go ahead.
Hi, Good evening, everybody. I'll make this kind of short. I got a bad voice tonight. First of all, our Civil Service Commission met on March 9th, and our chairman, Don Spirit, was his last meeting. He had been on the commission for 12 years, so it was kind of nice to, we had a little a pie, our Civil Service Secretary made a pie, and we had a little celebration for him, so it was kind of nice. And our new member, Leonard Taylor, was present at that meeting. He will not be sworn in until the next meeting, but he was there just to get a feel for the commission and what they do and how they operate. So before Don adjourned that meeting, though, they elected Tom Kornhoff to be the chairman of the Civil Service Commission going forward. So Lenny will be sworn in at the next meeting, which is April 6th. Also, in the meantime, on Saturday, March 18th, we had a fire entrance exam at Dodge School. We had 43 applicants take the test. 42 of them passed. All the letters were sent out this week, giving them their results, and then they had like this week to appeal any, and come in and review their test if they wanted to, or appeal any of their answers. And once that is finished, then at the meeting on April 6th, they'll go ahead and certify the list. The commission will certify the list. HR-wise, as the mayor said, we're getting everybody geared up for the HR, for the first aid training. That was kind of an outcropping of these meetings that we started having, the management roundtable meetings, where we just all get together, the department heads and some of the other management team, and discuss internal processes, because a lot of times when we get together as a group, we'll discuss community projects and bigger city kinds of things and council things and that. But just to get together as a group as to how we do things internally, how we process certain processes that we all deal with, like performance evaluations or a hiring process. Also, things like safety, we discuss safety, and we discuss safety training, a lot of different types of training. But this training was one of the first ones that we came out to. We wanted to get all the city employees CPR and first aid certified. So that's coming up, as the mayor said. We have a couple of open positions out there. We do have a plant attendant at our wastewater treatment plant, but we ended up taking that down because we had over 60 applicants in something like a week, some pretty qualified people. So we'll have plenty of people to choose from for that. We will have a full-time custodial position coming up also. IT-wise, as the mayor said, we're working on these badges. All the employees will be wearing them. We've got all the doors so that they're just, you know, proximity locks, or I think they're called. And then IT is also in the process of organizing the basement. It's a huge project. Did you have a question, Bill?
Do we get badges too?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You guys can
get
badges.
We don't have a badge.
And as I think I sent you the email for, you can get first aid trained too. So
I saw that.
Please come. The basement is getting organized. At IT, if you've ever been down there, it's like, oh my gosh, it's a huge room full of just a graveyard for IT stuff, and it's just an amazing amount of cords and cables and mice and keyboards and old monitors and software from the 90s, and I mean, just those guys never threw away anything. It's just, so anyway, we're sorting through it. Shannon's been very helpful in the process.
There'll be an auction list coming up.
Yeah, there'll be an auction list. Some of the stuff just needs to go, but some could be auctioned, some could be sold. So that's a big project that's going on right now with them. That's it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Actually, Leonard's here tonight. Why don't you wave to the crowd, Leonard? It's our new civil service member there.
Welcome.
One thing I forgot to mention, I mentioned the CERT team and the work that they do. So if you saw one of our past council meetings, I was able to recognize Wade Wooten. He was the man that pulled a lady out of a burning apartment. He's actually joined our CERT team, so
that's cool.
Our CERT team, so
nice.
So we have a new member. So, Larry?
Thank you. Good evening, Council.
Good evening.
Mr. Fury mentioned the Tax Incentive Review Council meeting. I'd just like to provide you a quick summary of what happened. The Turk met on the 22nd, last Wednesday. We reviewed 11 CRA agreements and 13 Twinsburg Occupancy Program agreements. The Turk recommended the continuance of 10 of the CRA agreements, so it's 10 of 11, and recommended continuance of 10 of the 13 top agreements. They recommended modification of one of the 11 CRA agreements, modification of two of the top agreements, and then also recommended termination of one of the top agreements. So you'll be seeing in the very near future, be preparing legislation for your action for each agreement. That'll be available at the next, for the next meeting. In addition, the CRA reports have to be mailed individually to the state and also have to be reported as a CRA project for the city to the state separately. That has to be done before the end of the month. So we're just about ready to submit that. Just an interesting fact about the top agreements. The top companies, the companies that are currently participating in the top program, contributed $1,741,000 of income tax to the city of Twinsburg last year. And it cost us $406,000 to keep those, to attract those companies here. So we had a payback of over four times the amount of the money we're giving up. And those agreements will be, you know, many of them are going to be slipping off into retirement over the next couple of years. Four of the CRA agreements will be terminated by the end of 2020. And nine of the top agreements will be ending by the end of the 2020 year. So we've set ourselves up with a number of good employers here, and I think top agreement in particular has been a very effective tool for the city. And the CAC managed the monitoring and the reporting, and we worked with Karen for the information from Rita to verify all the tax information. I just wanted to mention and thank a couple people here. We had a Northeast Ohio Development Exchange meeting sponsored by Twinsburg. We met here also on the 22nd. The subject of that meeting was basically the redevelopment of the former Chrysler site. 30 economic development professionals from all around Northeast Ohio attended the meeting here in this council room. It was followed by a tour of the Amazon facility, so everybody got to see how the Amazon facility is functioning. And I wanted to thank Derek for the use of the senior bus. We gave a couple of people a ride over to the Amazon facility with the senior bus, and Mark for his technical assistance on the IT stuff. So that is really the extent of my report tonight.
Thank you.
Thanks, sir. Karen,
you have something for him?
No. Good evening, Council. Can you believe we're already at the close of first quarter already? So I'm just going to give you a quick synopsis of our performance as far as what we collected for this year in a couple of areas. Particularly our income tax distribution for first quarter, we've received $1,461,980. Compared to last year, we received $1,512,387. So that reflects a decrease this year thus far, first quarter at 3.3%, or $50,000 less than last year. In refunds, we did refunds of $19,215. For year-to-date receipts collected, we are up by 7%. We received $5,024,378 thus far for first quarter, compared to last year, $4,683,238. The total net distribution for withholdings, net profits, as well as individual equates to $172,000 thus far for the first quarter. Also, just wanted to just kind of briefly touch on a little change that we did to diversify our portfolio, our investment portfolio. As a reflection of that, we made a little significant change as far as how we invested. It was mentioned briefly in our Finance Committee meeting today, but just to show you that we did do a very good change, and it has benefited the city thus far. We contracted with Meters Associates, they're an investment firm, to kind of diversify our portfolio, because it's a shame to say in this day and age that we get excited about like 0.1 basis point or 0.5 when about 10 years ago, we received over $500,000 in investments, versus in the previous years, such as like reflective, just touching on like 2011, we got excited about just getting $11,000. So over $500,000 versus $11,000 is like very, very extremely low. But that's the nature of our economy at this moment. But today, since we have made that significant change, we have seen a significant growth, starting reflective in 2015. Comparative, 2014, we collected in our investments $21,000. And you'll see the growth starting to occur. In 2015, since we made our portfolio, diversified our portfolio, $76,813. In 2016, our investments went up to $150,000. And currently for the first quarter, compared to last year, we're a little bit down, but so far we received $18,000 this year so far. So it looks like we're going in a good trend, and I think it was a good smart move that we did make. As it relates to our local state government, I think it is important that I do mention and continue to mention the fact that that is one area that we have definitely sought a significant reduction in. And our state local government, just rating from 2011, we were initially used to receive almost $300,000. That was one of the plans to reduce that fund gradually, and as a result of that, it went from $276,000 or $300,000 rounding up to a currently, 2016, $57,000, significantly dropped in that area. And right now, as of date, we're at $11,000. So that is one of the funds that you can slowly see that's going to be dissipating over the year, and I would anticipate that we will no longer see any collections in that area. And that's all I have to report. Any questions?
Thank you. Anything else? Do you want to wait till you report at the end?
I'd rather do it now. I forgot to mention for the residents in Hickory Hills and Heritage Hills, if the weather's good tomorrow, there's going to be a sewer project on the lower end of Gettysburg in the 8600 block, and we are going to have, the road's going to be blocked off at Hickory Hills and at Ravenna Road. So plan the alternate way for those of us who are going to have to go up around and out Laurel and out Presidential. That's it.
Okay. All set, Mayor?
So we have.
Okay. Time for legislation. Ordinance 22-2017.
An ordinance accepting the final subdivision plat for Shepherd Preserve, date stamped received November 2nd, 2016.
This is the, as Shannon mentioned, the final plat for Shepherd Preserve. This is, it's standing on its second reading. I'd like to make a motion to adopt Ordinance 22-2017. May I have a second?
I'll second.
Mr. Roden seconds. Discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Ceresi?
Yes.
Mr. Roden?
Yes.
Mr. Fury?
Yes.
Mr. Scafidi?
Yes.
Mr. Steele?
Yes.
Ms. McFerrin?
Yes.
Ordinance 22-2017 passes 6-0. Ordinance 36.
An ordinance amending section 105.01 of the codified ordinances of the City of Twinsburg, describing and identifying new boards and boundaries in accordance with the report of the Districting Commission as required by section 3.02 of the Charter of the City of Twinsburg.
This is the first reading on the redistricting of the City of Twinsburg. Resolution 37-2017.
A resolution appointing one member to the Environmental Commission.
I'd like to amend resolution 37-2017 by adding the name of John Boyko. Is there a second?
No second.
Thank you. Any discussion? All right, Shannon, can you please call the roll?
Mr. Roden?
Yes.
Mr. Fury?
Yes.
Mr. Ceresi?
Yes.
Mr. Scafidi?
Yes.
Ms. McFerrin?
Yes.
Mr. Steele?
Yes.
Motion passes 6-0. Now, I'd like to make a motion to adopt resolution 37-2017 as amended. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Discussion? Call the roll, please.
Mr. Ceresi?
Yes.
Mr. Roden?
Yes.
Ms. McFerrin?
Yes.
Mr. Fury?
Yes.
Mr. Steele?
Yes.
Mr. Scafidi?
Yes.
Resolution 37-2017 passes 6-0. Resolution 38.
a resolution appointing two members to the Capital Improvement Board.
I'd like to make a motion to adopt Resolution 38, 2017, adding Allison Doyle and Angelo Carciopolo to the Capital Improvements Board. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Mr. Steele, second. Discussion? Call the roll, please.
Mr. Sorese?
Yes.
Mr. Steele?
Yes.
Ms. McFerrin?
Yes.
Mr. Scafidi?
Yes.
Mr. Fury?
Yes.
Mr. Roden?
Yes. Resolution 38, 2017 passes 6-0. And that's it for our legislation. Unfinished business. Ms. McFerrin?
I don't have anything.
Mr. Steele?
Nothing.
Thank you. Mr. Roden?
I have nothing this evening. Thank you.
Mr. Scafidi?
I have nothing. Thank you.
Mr. Fury?
I'd like to thank Shannon for working with the engineering department to get our new map on the wall.
I like that.
For as long as I've been on council, my house wasn't on there, and it was built 18 years ago. Why that's important is not that my house is there, but we use that map in planning and other meetings to look at parts of the city, and you know, it looks really nice here, but it was really time to get that updated. Another thing I can notice here, but look at all the green space we have in the city of Twinsburg. When you see that, because we're not building roads through those dense areas, and did a nice job. Thank you very much.
Shannon.
Thank you, Shannon.
Welcome.
I would also like to wish Mr. Steele a happy birthday. He had one yesterday. I can't add that high. Happy birthday, Brian.
53 plus 8.
That's all.
Thank you. Mayor.
No, the only thing I want to say is just Mike actually ran out of here. Mike DeSillo. I just want to thank him for his years of service. I mean, it's for those who've ever sat and observed that board, Mike was a very important and part of that board. I mean, you know, they do have an interesting composure there, but you know, they really do take pride in how Twinsburg looks, and the Architect Review Board is really responsible for, you know, our developments. I've seen them fight with, you know, we have housing developments come through here, and they try to put homes in here with a complete, side with no windows. And but anyway, they do a lot of things in that board, and Mike was an important part of that for a number of years. So I just wanted to thank them for that.
Is that it?
That's all.
Thank you. I'd like to make a motion to excuse Mrs. Stauffer, who's out on vacation. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Mr. Roden seconds. Discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Sorese?
Yes.
Mr. Roden?
Yes.
Mr. Fury?
Yes.
Ms. McFerrin?
Yes.
Mr. Steele?
Yes.
Mr. Scafidi?
Yes.
The motion passes 6-0. Any other miscellaneous? We are adjourned. Thank you.